needle by needle. The shell style embroidery is very detail-oriented. For example, they can duplicate picture just exactly, and also need some special skills. For example, a skilled worker can split the threads to hundreds different threads and so on. So need good fingers, good eyes, and some skills. Like this girl working on this picture, it takes about 2 to 3 months to finish one picture.
Colorful combinations consisting of silk, floss, or cotton thread are used depending on the particular aspect of needlework, appreciate to the subject form.
From a research, I learned that Ma Wangdui tomb really reflects the prosperous period of Han Dynasty in China. Back then, they have a really good lifestyle. They have music, dance, ballroom dance, big stage shows. So let's go inside to take a look at the items that can prove what I just told you. Let's go.
Ma Wangdui Museum displays the early Han period tombs of a noble family excavated at Ma Wangdui, are among the most important archaeological discoveries of the past quarter century. The astonishing state of preservation of one of the tombs.
The location is about 4 kilometers from downtown Changsha.
Including the mummified corpse of massacres of Dai, and precious materials such as lacquer-painted wood and silk textiles. In addition, the tomb contains manuscript texts of versions of classic scriptures from early Chinese philosophical schools. The tombs also contain silk funerary paintings which offer insights into early imperial age mythologies. The tombs were discovered in 1972 during construction work at Ma Wangdui, about 4 kilometers northeast of Changsha, and the excavation was completed in 1974.
This sculpture, duplicated from the original map, is a physical chart for exercise. It indicates back 2,000 years ago, people really, really want to be healthy, so they are really exercise a lot. It's different styles, different positions. For example, that for your arm, and also good for your back if you do that. Oh, and that, ow!
The best preserved, entirely undisturbed tomb was that of the Marquis of Dai, or Xindui, buried about 180 BC. Whose husband was a minor nobleman in charge of administering the region of Changsha. The tomb walls were surrounded by layers of charcoals and pounded clay, which seemed to have been instrumental in keeping the moisture level constant and preventing the decay of the corpse and other tomb contents.
The actual coffin was buried 20.5 meters deep underground, and this is extra size. The body of the old lady was buried in the middle, and the spaces around it fulfilled with the rich items, silk, lacquerware. You know, it's a rich old lady. It's nice to be rich, even you're dying. Baisha Old Well has brought fresh water for Changsha people through hundreds of years since Song Dynasty. For example, This was recorded in different dynasty. Artists written water in different shapes in Chinese character. Dongjin Dynasty, Sui Dynasty, Song Dynasty, water, water, more water, more water, endless water. Every day, Changsha people come here together drinking water. It's quite a scene right now. And they take all kinds of containers, and some people come by bike, motorcycle, cars. I even seen two soldiers come here by fire truck to get this fresh water. 能不能给我试一口?
可以。嗯,差点差点不了点。好,停吧。
Like I said, it's a longevity water. You drink this, you can live forever. The Baisha water is so famous, make the Baisha liquors, Baisha cigarettes, Baisha restaurants, Baisha tea house. This water named the Baisha, and after the Baisha, they make everything.
Fire Temple is the best choice for tasting the local cuisine. It has over 100 years of history with various unique items in the tea house, food court, and banquet-style restaurant. However, there are more than one Fire Temples in Changsha City. Only the one on Bozi Street is original.
The Fire Palace has started as a temple for people come here pray to the fire god to protect their business and home. And then in the 19th century, and they start to develop it, import it more equipment, such as fire truck. In the recent years, this place has been redeveloped. New restaurants opened, offers gourmet Hunan food. And every weekend, they invite artists performing here, so visitors should come over here to taste the gourmet Hunan food and see some beautiful shows. Especially, you can get the best stinky tofu right here in the restaurant behind me. In the Fire Temple compound, it's very busy in the morning. Open 6 o'clock in the morning every day. There is 300-400 people come over here. People come here, enjoy the environment here, social with the friends, talk about the families, each other's, you know, business, and also some antique collectors come here to make a business deal. Huge cup, isn't it? A cup of tea only costs 2 yuan. Thank you. As a fake head chef, let me introduce you some real Hunan gourmet. First of all, our favorite dish is this big giant fish head. It's cooked, steamed, soaked in the oil. Top is pepper, very spicy. Second one is very special. It's a turtle head. You might don't like it, me neither, but it's a local special. Let me go on the third one. It's the beef. Come take a close look. It's a beef stomach. And then the one, the only, I need some drum. That's the one, the only, the best, the local favorite is the stinky tofu. You want to know how stinky, come over here, don't run away. You want to know how stinky it is? Let me tell you, if I push it towards the TV set, don't run, you can smell it at home.
but it tastes very good. There we go. Here we have the real Hunan Gourmet. So ask me, which one you like the first?
As early as the Western Han Dynasty, which is 2,100 years ago, the cooking skills of Hunan cuisine reached a high standard.
What am I gonna have today? Maybe I start with a little fish, beef, pork, chicken, a little shrimp, scallop. Well, let me have some tea first. The food here is very good, and the tea even better. Actually, it's too early. What should I do? What do you guys do after the meal? What I want to do? I really want to take a nap. All right, I think that's a good decision. I'm gonna go take a nap. Hunan food is well known in the world. Come to Changsha, I start to understand. It's not only spicy, but also with its style. For example, this one, it's not a palace, it's a restaurant, Xihulou Restaurant. According to Guinness Record Book, it's the biggest one in Asia.
To make a full use of its rich natural resources, the owner of Xihulou Restaurant created a wide variety of delicacies. Hunan cuisine consists of more than 4,000 dishes, among which more than 300 are very famous. Changsha people is well known for their easygoing attitude. Come to a luxury style of spending the spare time, there are many options. Sitting in a quiet local tea house, sipping a cup of a green tea is one of my favorite picks. In the weekend, Jiefang Street in downtown area is the most fully occupied district. Many bars and nightclubs will work diligently on showcase their specialties. Due to the entire hard-working week, I passed this chance of visiting. But you can count on me, I will be back.